I stood counted, I didn't vote though. Don't talk about splashing, I own a boatload. They say, man overboard when I'm involved, so my lighthouse will stay lit. I'm taking photos, ultraviolet light, ultra flashes, ultralight beams. If they took a chance on the rapper, they'll notice me. I only get lost at sea when I'm going deep. The dreadlock nest got a rise, they call me free. Hey!
I was about to start my sentence with call me biased, but it's not even a biased thing. You know, we're talking about the great writers when we're talking about Rich Ritu.
Working with Rich is a very diverse experience. Like, you go through different stages. I feel like the main thing with Rich is he always knows what he wants.
He's unique in the sense that every word and every line has a purpose. His thought process of linking those words from an emotive standpoint really can connect with people.
Cheers.
Yeah, just good, brother. Take care, man.
So when we was in combination camp, Rich was the last member to join, but he was the one that took it more serious. So he was the one that was writing songs. For us, it was more of a lifestyle. It was just what we done. We never ever saw that this could be a business or a sector that we could live in and work in. And with Rich on it, he was obsessed. In the time it took us to record a mixtape, which takes like one verse from each person, he had recorded his own. So it was just clear to everyone that he was more serious about music. Like, he was obsessed with writing songs and trying to push the boundaries and try something difficult.
I'm Rich, yeah. My name is Rick North. Of course, I'm so better. I'm next, my flow's gloss. I'm awkward like weather. My tent's below frost. I'm fortunate, brothers. I vex. I'm so gone.
Now, Mo, when it comes to training or psyching yourself up before a race, what do you listen to music-wise?
I listen to Fire in the Booth.
You're just saying that because you're at One Extra.
I'm serious. Fire in the Booth.
Who's done the best ever Fire in the Booth?
Oh, man, it'd have to be Rich.
We've had fun creating this body of work. This is the 3-2 album, the year I'm 32. So this is in the back of the mind, always been a special one. So I thought it's nice to do something different with it. So that's why everyone's here today. I appreciate everyone's feedback. I just don't want to hear that it's shit. It's obviously not good. That's a private number. We don't need that. Yeah. You got that as well?
Yeah,
I don't know. Who do you think it is?
I don't know.
Might be H. Yeah, anyone that knows me knows that from like the first time I ever started fiddling around with lyrics, this was like the thing that I fell in love with, innit? And it's never changed. At the end of the day, I'm just a vessel, and everything that I record and write is something that has happened to me in real life or a story that I've heard from one of you lot in the room. I want to thank everyone for having patience with me during this process, especially everyone that came away, that worked in the 30-day Red Bull session that we had, that worked in the King's Cross session that we had, that worked in the session where I took everyone away from their families and we worked out in the farmyard. That was special for me to know that you're willing to come away from your comfort zone, come away from your home, come away from where you live and spend 5 days with me. But for me, during these recording process, this is probably like the most frustrating time to be around me. But you have to understand, like, in my life, music's one of the only things that has never done me wrong. So the level that I care about it is beyond words. So when things ain't going right with the songs, or when things ain't going right with the rollout, or when things ain't going right with the video, it's stressful and it's borderline bipolar and depression sometimes. So everyone around me who always keeps me uplifted when I'm down is essential. Obviously I play it down, but it's a serious thing, man. Like, sometimes when the album's not going right, I feel like shit, man. You know what I mean? The records, if I'm not hitting what I feel like I can hit, I'm not reaching my potential, I feel like shit. In this journey of life, like, we're all put here to do something, and I think even if money didn't exist, I would still make music, because that's how much it means to me. Like, it's not about a profit. It's just fortunate that I'm able to provide for my family and my loved ones through it. But if money didn't exist, I would always record.
Yeah.
like, first of all, he doesn't write lyrics. He's got to do it. He just does it in his head. You know, talks to everyone around him, spit the bars here, spit the bars there. You know what I mean? And just feed off everyone else's energy. I think, I don't know, the beginning, the like, first two lines is the kind of, how can I put this? So for example, when you pivot, like for example, you have one foot down and you pivot all the way around. When you come back around, that foot's still there. So like, I feel like the first two lyrics or the first couple of lyrics is like the foot that's still there. By the time you get to the end, it's like the basis of the whole verse. It's like, it almost sums it up before there's anything to sum up, I don't know. Maybe you might listen to this and call me and say, yo, nah, that's not it. Why are you trying to do that? But I think that's like a science that is behind the genius.
I like working with Rich because you never know exactly what you're going to get with Rich. He knows what he wants, but there's times where, you know, he may come in and he might not get his idea there and then, but he knows the ones that he has to come back to.
Nah, baby girl made me wanna. Hey. I was just amazed with the body. I was in a rage for the body, then I had her in a rage. Take your body, stay safe when you're on me. Good thing I rave with my journey. I had to tell her to her face that I'm cocky, so God forgive me if I bust my nine. Bust my nine, oh. God forgive me if I bust my nine. Bust my nine, oh. God forgive me if I bust my nine. I bust my nine, oh. God forgive me if I bust my nine. May I go bust my nine?
It's not right, innit? It's not right, Spec. Because I was sitting there and I'm thinking, why didn't I finish this though? Because I like it, but I'm like, that's why. It just feels like it just feels like you got on a train and it didn't move.
I remember you saying vividly as well that you said that it felt disconnected. Each section didn't correlate.
It's confusing though. Because when it gets like this, I like to figure it out so I don't feel defeated, but it's just like, it's not right. Like, it's not crap, like, but it's just not right. It's making you feel underwhelmed, isn't it?
And he knows the ones that he's like, yo, we've got something in this one, but we need to finish it later.
It was emotional because he had contacted myself and Mikey and told us of the passing of his uncle. He was unsure if he was going to come. So me and Mikey were kind of just like, even if you don't come, we get it, it's not a problem.
I went to the hospital with my mum and my aunt, and he passed away. That's like the first time I'd like seen like a dead body in like the hospital. After I dropped my mum home, it was like I had a session that night with Mikey and Mo, and I just thought, you know what, I got so much I want to say.
But then he hits us and he's like, he's going to come to the studio, and we're like, okay.
I didn't want to go home, I didn't want to stay at my mum's, it just felt too, everything felt too, like, I don't know, depressing, so I thought, let me go studio and get what I have off my chest.
He came and Mikey was playing the chords.
It just got me thinking about time.
He was just like, I'm ready. And for a second, it was weird because it's like, he was really, really trying to not show the emotion of what has just happened, you know what I mean? Like, his mum in a tearful mood, it was crazy how he was just holding it all in.
And the chorus in this song, it's not really a chorus, it's like an intro and an outro, but the chorus says, time won't be on your side like I will. And I say that because, I mean, for as long as I can, I will always be by your side. But there's an overall clock that none of us have our eye on, and we can't anticipate when that second's gonna dial into our minute. It just made me think about life, so I kind of just went and recorded the first half of this record because we couldn't finish it on that day.
And then as he jumped in the booth and, you know, he was going through and he's writing a song, the emotions just all came out.
It was too much.
It was too much, and we actually had to stop the session. He was very, very, very in a sad, you know, teary situation, you know what I mean? And at that point, we just had to really, really comfort him and console him because, you know, losing anyone that's lost someone knows the impact that it has, especially when it's family. And so it was a difficult session because he didn't finish the song. So we was like, how are we gonna finish this song if tomorrow, you come back tomorrow, you're not in that same emotion, do you know what I'm saying? But somehow he was able to come back and do it. But anything that touches on, you know, what he's been through and his family, he's very, you know, he becomes very emotional. So it was a difficult session, but I think it, through its difficulty, we were able to get the best moment, like, you know what I mean, for him. And he was able to, really pour his heart and emotion onto that song. So yeah, I mean, it's definitely one of my favorites.
My son, my mama, my sister made some noise one time.
As soon as we finished Growing Up My Life, we came back into the studio and we basically was like, what did we not do on the album? What did we know on the album? And we started making records to kind of like answer that question, which was just to have that record he can come out and perform. On, let's say he came off of Conan, having a song that he can perform and people are like, oh yeah, that's Rich's song. I think Growing Up My Life was, like Mo said, that conversational album where it's like, I have a lot to say, to speak about. I haven't dropped an album in a minute, so I'm gonna give you that, and people appreciate it. That major love gave us paper cuts. The wall I do strict one, come tape with us. Might do it straight, there's no chasing love, and that's a sign that I'm crossing, I've lost faith in y'all. But me lucky that me still there, I rode there. Karma still spinning around by that road there. Told me that it's done in the dance, running the dance. Said she didn't wanna come, I told her, come as you are, just come as you are.
The music relationship began when he messaged me on Twitter after seeing a video that I put up with my boy Hurricane Hunt. He was just like, give me a number, spoke to him, he'll come studio. Working on my album. Obviously at the time, that's mad. I'm like, bruh, what do you mean? Come studio straight away, not even a,
I wanna see now, come!
Cause normally what they do, normally what the big guys do, is like, yeah man, you're doing your thing, man, keep going, and just pat you on the back and let you move along. But he's just like, yo, come, let's go studio and work on the album, which was, which taught me a lot of, you know, about him as a person, and it's something that I always remember when I'm speaking to a younger person.
Man in the mirror, yeah, that's me again. Running back and forth with a lee of them.
First thing he does is wake up thinking about music. When booking this studio out, it's an expensive studio and the cost involved in it and all the rest. So if he could live in a place like this, do you know what I mean? So it's just one of those things. If you're creative, you just want to be creative.
My thing is different now.
We're going to play it from top to bottom. We're taking money pull-ups, just letting him have it. He's gonna go to the Gretsch. He's gonna go to the Rich 3-2 trust fund.
Just the worst as well, man.
No, just. He's gonna go to the trust fund. And yeah, man, that's why everyone to enjoy the body of work, take it in. If there's anything you wanna pull up anytime, you wanna stand up, you wanna vibe, it's entirely up to you. But let's take in this album, man. 3-2.
Come on, yeah!